Hi everyone, my name is Mikel Lufrerías and I'm gonna tell you, give you a brief summary on LETS, which stands for Least Enhanced Temperature Subsystem. I will give you this brief summary on behalf of the LETS Consortium, which is composed by people at IEC in Barcelona, our colleagues at DLR in Bremen, and also our industrial partner Sener in Barcelona as well. First of all, a bit of motivation. Why do we need temperature monitoring in LISA? So the reason is that temperature fluctuations can play a very important role in space-borne gravitational wave detectors like LISA, and they typically can have an effect in the sub-millihertz window, in the low-frequency window where precisely LISA will be operating. There are several effects that can induce either displacement or forced noise in LISA. One of them is temperature gradients across the test mass that could produce forces on the test mass that we are able to measure. The optical window, for instance, optical elements like the optical window, which is a non-bonded optical element that acts as the interface, the optical interface between the GRS and the optical bench. So thermal gradients there could produce thermoelastic effects, and also temperature gradients in the structure itself, for instance, on these thermal gradients on these struts that hold the experiment inside the thermal shield, could be the origin as well as of thermally induced mechanical stress effects. All of these have already been tested on ground during the LISA Pathfinder development and also during in-flight operations. So indeed, in LISA Pathfinder, we had a temperature measurement subsystem composed by 24 high-precision sensors and 16 heaters to do local experiments in certain locations. The basic idea behind this temperature measurement subsystem was to use an AC-powered Wiston bridge using NTC sensors, and the basic characteristics, as I said, is that we were using NTC sensors instead of platinum sensors, because although these are more reliable, the NTCs are much more sensitive. We were using six different scales to have a wide range of temperatures that we can measure, but on each of these scales we had a high resolution. And something important in the development is that we had to develop also a test facility where we were able to suppress environment temperature fluctuations in the environment so that we were able to really validate the electronics and the subsystem that we were developing. The results of this, the in-flight results of this temperature measurement system, you can see here in this picture. And you basically, the picture basically shows is that we reached the floor noise of 10 microkelvin root hertz roughly, and in the region below 1 millihertz typically we detected an excess noise that was basically due to ADC non-linearities. We already knew about this, and it was not so critical for LISA Pathfinder because the measurement band on LISA Pathfinder was to 1 millihertz, but for LISA this is something that we need to take into account because LISA will go down to 10^-4 hertz. So LETS is precisely a project to focus or let's say to address these issues. It stands for Least Enhanced Temperature Subsystem, and it's basically an ESA-funded activity to develop and test a prototype of the future LISA temperature subsystem. The team, as I said, is composed by IEC, DLR, and Sener, and it's an activity that originally was planned to finish on November 2020, but due to the COVID lockdown, there will be a delay, and we think we will basically finish the activity around January, February. The objective is, as I said, to design a prototype of this temperature measurement subsystem, which the objective is that it has to reach a performance of 1 microkelvin root hertz down to 1 millihertz. We will be testing around 16 sensors, and the activity includes the development of a front end, the development of a ultra-stable test bench, the integration, verification, and test of everything, and to design a roadmap to reach TRL 6. The current status of this is that we are waiting for the test readiness review in September to then start the testing phase. Here, if we come back to the performance in Lisa Pathfinder, the idea is basically that we will go one order of magnitude better in performance in the down to 1 millihertz with a small relaxation on frequencies below the millihertz. There are two blocks on this LEDS project. One is the temperature measurement subsystem and the other is the test bench. On the temperature measurement subsystem, we have the design is split in three different PCBs. One is the analog front end, which implements the measurement itself with the DACs, the ADCs, and the readout, basically, the analogic readout. Then we have the power distribution and the digital processing board. Here you see the main, the basic characteristics and some pictures of it. The analog board basically implements a low noise acquisition. It has three different scales, and of course, it has a very low dependency with temperature, as required for a high sensitive temperature measurement subsystem. It implements 14 channels, and some of them have the possibility to implement differential measurements between two sensors. The idea behind this measurement is again a Wheatstone bridge, but in this time we are using a sine signal instead of a square signal as we were using in Pathfinder. The digital processing has a microcontroller unit, which allows for double precision floating point, and also has support for digital signal processing and other features that you see here and you can check on the slides. And finally, the power distribution board. We have also developed a software for this unit. In fact, we have two different software, one on the host PC, which reads, decodes packets, saves data, and things like that. And the other, this is implemented in Python, the other implemented in C, that runs on the digital part, on the temperature measurement subsystem itself, which is written in C, and basically controls the ADC, the DAC, and takes care also of the packaging and the communication with the PC. Here I show you some expected performance on the central scale from these three scales that we have, and you see that when we are centered around these 25 degrees, we will be basically having a performance in blue here on the right, which is below the 1 microkelvin root hertz as expected. And you see here also some pictures of these boards already built and implemented and being integrated in our lab, ready for start testing during the next weeks. The second block of the project is the test bench subsystem. The test bench is designed as a vacuum chamber with three aluminium thermal shields acting as low pass filters. On the outer shield, we have a Peltier's elements that will allow us an active control of the temperature of this outer shield. The middle layer, the middle shield, has a host, a thermal trap for the harness to avoid thermal leakage of this harness from the outside to the inside. And finally, on the inner part, we have this aluminium block, which we will place our sensors. This inner aluminium block is something you can see here in more detail. It basically hosts the sensor under test that we will connect to our front end outside, and also other sensors that are used for internal calibration. So we have 12 slots for LEDs sensors, and other slots that we use for high accuracy platinum sensors or other technologies like silicon diode sensors that we will be measuring here to do cross-check measurements during the testing. In terms of the expected performance of this test bench, you see here In red, you see our the LEDs requirement of our front end. The tense range needs to go one order of magnitude better in order to suppress all temperature fluctuations, so to allow our front end to measure only the noise of the front end itself. And here you see the requirements. And this line in blue here is the expected applying our model of the design that I have just shown you. This is the expected temperature fluctuations inside the aluminium block, which you will see. So according to the, if we start assuming an environment outside in the lab. So as you see, the temperature fluctuations that we are expecting in the block, in the aluminium block, in the inner part of this test bench are well below the requirements that we need to fulfill. Here you see a picture of this test bench where you see the three aluminium layers. This is the inner part of the vacuum chamber. Inside you see already a picture, some parts of the aluminium block where the sensors will be. Here on the outer part you see the Peltier elements in this structure, inside this structure. And as I said, all of these will be inside a vacuum chamber. So to end, I will just give you a brief summary. As I said, LEDs is an ESA-funded activity to develop a TRL-4 temperature measurement subsystem for LISA. The team is composed by people at IEC, Barcelona, DLR, Bremen, and SENER. The main aim of the project is to develop, design, manufacture, and test a high-precision temperature subsystem reaching the 1 microkelvin root hertz, and set a roadmap towards TRL-6. This also includes a very challenging activity, which is to design a test bench able to suppress the environment fluctuations below the front-end floor noise. And the current status of this is that the units are already being manufactured, they are ready. We had already run a first test that they are successful. And we expect to hold this test readiness review in September and then start our testing phase to finish around January, February next year. And that's all. Thank you a lot for your attention. Ciao.